For the final match tonight, 8-man over the top battle royal. We have all 8 participants of the Money in the Bank match taking part in it, and Kane wins by eliminating both Christian and CM Punk. And this is where the learning comes in for my roommate Josh. He done a good job. He's like, Kane's going to eliminate them both, and Kane eliminated them both. So he done a good job there. I'm proud. I'm proud of my protege. I'm going to call him my protege for right now. I might come up with another name for him. I don't know. We'll see. My apprentice. There you go. Except I won't be Donald Trump. Then we have Orton's WrestleMania address, and it just basically was a bunch of videos showing what led up to what's leading up to the match at WrestleMania and whatnot. Basically just Orton taking out each family member of Triple H's here. And basically afterwards, the announcement that was going to change the WWE Universe was that if Triple H gets counted out or disqualified, he will automatically lose the title, and it will be awarded to Orton. And if he brings a sledgehammer out, it's going to be an automatic disqualification, and Orton gets the title. So there we are. That's the stipulation. It could be changed, maybe. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But a limo pulls up, and the doors are open. No one's in it. No one to be found when the cameras get there. And then all of a sudden we hear, no chance. And here comes Vince McMahon. He takes off his tie, rips off his tie, takes off his jacket, rolls his sleeves up. He's ready to fight. And then we hear, here comes the money. Shane McMahon comes out. And then, of course, it wouldn't be complete unless we had the favorite son-in-law to Vince McMahon, Triple H. And actually, I think this is only son-in-law, so that's all right. So Vince, Shane, and Triple H end up brawling with Cody Rhodes, Ted DiBiase, and Jr., and Randy Orton. And that is how the show ends. And this was my second favorite segment of the night, mainly because the McMahons have returned, and they're ready to brawl. So, we may see them in the corner of Triple H at WrestleMania. We may see the stipulations change, because Vicky Guerrero can be trumped by Vince McMahon, because he is the chairman of the WWE. So, we'll have to wait and see if there's any change in that stipulation that she made. But as far as it goes, the segments made the night for me tonight once again. There wasn't really a match that stood out that I could say, hey, that was a great match. But it was mainly the segments that won me over for making this an okay Raw tonight. I guess I'm learning to live with the segments. I don't know. But overall, with it being the last Raw before WrestleMania, they had to build up the matches and whatnot. And they did that, especially with Orton versus Triple H, as well as Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels. And they promoted the rest of the matches also, but mainly Orton, Triple H, and Taker, Shawn Michaels. So that's my thoughts and recap of Raw this week. Post your thoughts below. Just let me know what you thought of it. If you agree, if you disagree, if you like waffles, if you like to share that information with me, go feel free to. As always, thank you for watching. And I will hopefully be back later this week, either by myself or with my esteemed colleague, my apprentice Josh, to do a WrestleMania 25 prediction video. So you guys take it easy, have a great week, and I will hopefully see you all either tomorrow or later this week.